Hey, can we talk about Phoebe? In the last few episodes, Phoebe's wildly changing stances on Cole. Like, she went from I'm deeply in love with him to not only do I never want to see that guy again, I'm going to summon him just to kill him, to I'm deeply in love with him and I can save him. It's like an emotional whiplash with Phoebe. No gradual change, just very flip. And all because he said, basically in the last episode, he said, Rhaenyra put a spell on me or something, tricked me into killing her. And that's basically all the explanation he gave. Is that enough to make the difference between I'm going to kill you right now and I'm deeply in love with you and I'm going to save you? He should have said that in the second last episode. He was too cut up about killing that woman. He was too in shock. He was in total shock about it. So when they were throwing random accusations at him, he just couldn't. He was trying to, and he was feeling so weak as well because of the amulet stuff, and he wasn't able to defend himself properly. I just find it funny that she's gone from one extreme side to the other so quickly. Just gradually ease into it, Phoebe. Ease into your emotions. That's what I would learn from Piper. Take some meditation from Piper and just ease back into it. Hey, Cole isn't the monster you thought he was in the last episode. That's great. You still love each other. He's still a demon. We can work with it. We can slowly get back that trust and do something about it. Now, it's the finale. Finale time. What do we expect? All hell breaking loose. What happened? First finale, Andy died, right? Second finale, what happened in the second finale? I know Piper and Leo at the very end because at the start of season 3 we're still waiting for them to come back, but what actually happened in that episode? That was near the Four Horsemen episode, wasn't it? The apocalypse and all that stuff. It's not really solid in my brain. It was around Dan going away too. It was around a lot of things like that. The Dan, Leo, Piper triangle, love triangle, in retrospect, a bit awkward. Dan's such a nice guy. In any other show, if he had gotten there first, we might be rooting for him, you know? But because Piper and Leo were locked in so quickly. Hey, remember when I thought Phoebe and Leo were going to get together? That Leo secretly liked Phoebe back in the really early days? Anyway, this is all to say is that I can't remember the end of season 2. Too well? What was it called? That episode? Yeah, the second last episode was called Apocalypse Not. And then the last one was called Be Careful What You Wish For. Oh, which had that witch genie from Third Rock from the Sun. That guy. Yeah, that's an odd episode to end it on. Right. Are you ready? Stretch. Stretch my brain. Keep my wits about me. And talk to YouTube. Hey everybody, it is the finale of season 3 of Charmed. Episode 22. This episode is called All Hell Breaks Loose. Which is a very literal title, I imagine, in this show. For any other show, you'd be like, oh, shit hits the fan, I guess. But in this show, hey, I think hell's opening up. Lots of demons and banshees and warlocks and grimlocks and Friday the 13th guy and tempests and Abraxas and all sorts of people. They're all going loose. Or something? Or maybe it's just a metaphorical title. I don't know. All I know is that it's the finale. So, usual rules don't apply. You know? People could be in jeopardy. And, people could be in jeopardy mid-season too. But I'm less worried about people like in episode 7 of a series, of a show. I presume everybody's going to be in it. The whole gang. We had Kit last episode, speaking of the whole gang. And we also had a dog. Did you see that episode? It was a dog and a cat. And P3 was in it. And there was a bust up at the mausoleum. And a lot of windows got broken. A lot of structural damage to those windows. That guy who replaces that window in their home, he should put in like some sort of super strong titanium glass or something, shouldn't he? Anyway, let's get into it.
Okay, I think we made it.
Who the hell is this?
I think he would have attacked by now if we
had. Who's this guy?
Who would have attacked? Why won't you tell me what's going on?
Because we're busy trying to save your life.
From who?
Unfortunately, we're not quite sure. I saw the attack. We kicked butt. What more do you want? Maybe you should check the Book of Shadows, see if you can find anything else on this demonic hitman, okay?
Hitman?
Now you're talking about demons and witches? Who the hell are you people?
Hey,
I know that this
dude.
Either you have saved too many lives, or you're about to save a life that they don't want you to save. More specifically, Shax, who is the source's assassin.
Shax?
This is a practical joke, right? Just got a hidden camera here.
Just sit down and watch TV, dude.
Listen to me. This is anything but.
Do you hear something?
What? I don't know. I just
use your dog ears.
Chill, Phoebe.
Oh, it's a twister. Oh, jeez.
Dear God.
No.
Prue. Prue. Piper. Phoebe. Can we stop him?
Evil wind that blows, that which forms below, that you with this spell.
Yeah. Good job, Phoebe. Are there the other two okay?
Oh, God.
Oh, jeez.
Leo?
Leo, where the hell are you?
Leo! Hurry, it's bad.
Save him. You save him. Where was he?
What happened?
You guys almost died, that's what happened.
Oh, where's Shax?
Well, I tried to use the vanquishing spell. He turned into the wind.
To go find him, so we can finish him off while he's still hurt. Come on.
Leo, fix up our house. That wall needs to be fixed. Oh, that guy's still here.
He's gotta be around here somewhere. You really think he'd attack us in broad daylight?
He's right behind you. Nice. Is he
dead?
I don't think so.
Lucky nobody saw us. Just get back to Phoebe. Come. Back to me.
Okay,
Why are you
I'm
here?
I'm not exactly sure what just happened, but whatever it was, you saw it here. Live.
Careful, lady. Last person who took footage of them? Prue killed. She snapped his neck. Yeah, Grimlocks. That episode. Yeah, Darl, watch your back, Darl. Everybody watch their backs. Kit, watch your back. Kit won't be in it. He's still here.
Hey.
Now you understand why you have to keep this a secret. If others knew, we wouldn't be able to do what we do anymore.
No, I understand.
He gets it.
So much for my being an atheist. Your secret is safe with me.
Okay, I'll walk you to the door. I mean, something still bothers me about the way that we vanquished Shax.
He didn't
like,
seem...
I'm not so sure we really did.
Yeah.
What do you mean? He went poof, just like they all do.
No, I didn't really...
Third demon in a row, by the way, that I vanquished with my new power, but who's counting?
And why was there a vanquishing spell in the book?
Well, except the book was written by witches with less powers than you guys have.
And plus, I think if he was still alive, he probably would have attacked again by now.
Let's talk about everything that you just said. Leo makes a good point. That, although, see, good points all around, because the spell's in the book to, this is the spell to vanquish the guy, right? So you might imagine, hey, shit, we didn't say the spell, so maybe normal powers just don't work on the guy. We need to say the spell or he's going to still be out there. But Leo's saying that, hey, you, that book was written by just normal, regular witches. You're the charmed ones. You, the shit you've done, the powers you got, you know, maybe you're almost past all this stuff in the book. You know, you maybe Piper's power is good enough to, for some of these people who normally need spells. Now, do I think that's true? Not in this case. Because they're making such a big deal about the way the guy disappeared. Feels like he's still out there. And kind of looks disgusting, doesn't he? Kind of looks weird. Also, why was there a camera crew? Were they filming across the road about this, the dispute between the neighbors and their trash? We're here at local houses where a trash dispute has spilled out into the streets. Oh, what's happening over there? Did you get that? Or maybe it's all linked in somehow, I don't know. Anyway, it's another one of those episodes that starts with a in the middle of the action. You know, some episodes keep you off your toes because they start... Some episodes start with them having breakfast and you're like, they ease you into it. But some are just like, oh, a demon is here. Oh.
You just check to make sure, please, with the elders.
No problem.
Yeah. Can we see the... Could you bring them down here?
I want to try a new potion on Cole. Phoebe, I'm not looking for your approval, Piper. Just your support. Maybe it's sort of hard to give you support when you're just setting yourself up to get hurt again. Cole is good inside. Hey. I know it. I can't just turn my back.
And he saved her from being a banshee.
I want you to use the magic to magic spell to set me down there.
If something goes wrong, we won't be able to contact each other.
I'll be safe. I'll be with Cole.
Wait, well, where?
Bring me back, so don't worry
about Sorry, that. Where are we going? Meanwhile, down at Cold Candle Lair, where is this place? Hey, buddy.
Cole.
Phoebe.
I came to bring you back.
You just made a huge mistake.
Come on, Cole. You still in there?
Hey, pipe down, everybody.
This quiet neighborhood is actually sitting on top of a fault line.
What the hell?
Ooh. It's a magic show.
I mean, you saw it. What else could it be other than something was supernatural?
Oh, come on, give me a break. For all we know, this is just a hoax.
Yeah.
Well, we can't put the genie back in the bottle, Dave.
Oh, genie.
200,000 viewers saw it live.
And a season two.
What do you want to do?
Go find out who these women are, fast.
What did you expect to find?
I don't know, something though.
Frankly, I'm more worried about Phoebe than Shax.
Phoebe can take care of herself, Dr. Griffiths can't. Look, there's one thing I've learned since becoming a witch.
Oh, who's this?
Is to trust those feelings.
Hi.
Who are you?
Come on, sweetie. Stay away from them.
Stay away. Oh, they saw the TV thing? I was freaked out by the child. Hey, Darryl, buddy. Don't get shot, dude.
Morris, looks like all those freaky rumors about you and the Hollywells might not have been rumors after all.
What are you talking about?
What do you mean? Oh, no.
Oh, maybe that's Griffiths. No, Daryl, just wait. Slow
yeah, Daryl.
Down, okay?
Have you seen the TV yet today?
I told the captain I would handle this, but I can't afford them all for long.
Stand by. Okay,
oh
we're now going to switch
God.
Live to Alana.
Here we are approaching the home of where they get out of there. Live. Prue, Piper, and Phoebe Hallowell.
Oh, she knows their names.
And you're going to meet them right here on KCSF.
I'm not answering the door.
What are we going to do?
Look, are you coming to arrest them? Do you consider them dangerous?
Hey, I can help. I know who they are, man. I know what they are. They're witches, just like I am.
Just like you.
I said no comments.
Get out of here.
Isn't that illegal? Can't you do something about that?
Killing somebody live on TV is pretty illegal too, you know.
He might not be dead.
It was a demon, and we're pretty Shax. Sure we didn't kill him anyway.
This thing's gonna get ugly fast.
What do we do?
We shouldn't have followed Shax into the street.
They're gonna be famous.
Sure, we could have let him kill our innocent. That would have been better, you think? Maybe when Phoebe's done saving Cole, she can come back and save us. Hello, Leo.
Leo.
Nice of you to orb in. Where have you been?
Trying to figure out how to get you out of this mess.
Any suggestions?
No, they're still working on it.
Damn it.
If we can't fix this, it could undermine all the good that you've done and all the good that you're still destined to do.
Destiny, you know. Surely there's contingencies for this.
While the elders are figuring out what we're supposed to do, we still have work to do.
Dr. Griffiths?
Orbis to the hospital, okay?
I can't. The elders won't let me. They don't want to risk exposing White Lighters to.
This time.
I need to talk to you!
Go, 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 go!
Please take me!
I love this witch. She's a wannabe. She wants in.
You're not an easy girl to dump. Even if you could reverse, it doesn't change the fact that I...
That you killed a witch. Yeah, I know, Cole, but you didn't do it willingly, and that's the difference.
Ooh. She did it. Is this gonna work?
Pretty cool potion, huh?
Well, he's kissing her. It's better than choking her out. How are you feeling?
Let's get out of here. Back to my place.
You really think they're just gonna let me go? They're not gonna come looking for me again?
We'll fight them off.
Phoebe, we tried it up there. It doesn't work for us.
So where does that leave us?
Right where we are.
Oh, yes.
Oh, this doctor. Will he survive?
Hi! He's still after you. Come on!
I thought you said you got rid of this
thing! Yeah, well, we don't think that anymore, okay?
Where are we going?
Oh, the reporters. They're always here!
No longer may you dwell, death takes you with this spell!
Power 2!
Now that was a vanquish.
Ooh!
They're heroes.
Uh-oh.
Heroes.
News at 11.
It's probably live, Piper. It was live last time. The end is near. Oh, this one. She's the only one who understands. Need to talk about that woman. Hey, woman, you're a witch, right? That's what you claim anyway? There's plenty of witches in San Francisco. And they meet up. Like, a few episodes ago in the park, remember? That woman with the amulet and everything? So, it's not like she's been out in the cold and she's been, like, has no one to connect with. There's like a whole underground culture of witches. They all sort of know each other, and they all... witches' shops and all sorts of things. I understand. These are superstar ones now. They made it to the TV. She's really fangirling up. What is her... She's been in three scenes now. Is she going to factor into it, or is it just a funny little... Is she just a funny little side character? Do you think they really kill Shax with just the power of two? Also, how does this get fixed? How do we undo this? Like, how do we get back to the status quo after this? We either don't, and they're famous, or wouldn't they be harassed all the time from people with all sorts of problems? They could open an agency to help people with hauntings and stuff, but if they wanted to undo it, it'd have to be time travel, right? Undo, go back and stop, not be filmed in the first place. We've done time travel before, and I'm sure the elders could arrange a little portal. Those are the two options. We either go back and stop it from happening so that nobody knows about them again, or we completely redefine the show itself and people do know about them. Or third option is that they somehow manage to convince people that it's just a hoax, that it's just like sleight of a hand, smoke and mirrors, you know. They turn it into a prank, a joke. So those are, that's where my mind is at the moment. Three possibilities. And we're also having an episode with Cole and Phoebe. It's the extra part.